It's Michelle from Lab Muffin Beauty Science, chemistry PhD, skincare nerd and tretinoin fan. Today I'm going to be talking about how to start on tretinoin, adapalene and other powerful retinoids. Tretinoin is one of the most science-backed skincare ingredients, but it's notoriously hard to start on. There's lots of peeling and irritation involved, and I might have gotten broken capillaries from the first time I tried retinol. There's even a technical name for this break-in period, retinization. So to help you start on it and to avoid all the mistakes I made, here are some tips on how to add it to your routine with minimal side effects so you can get the benefits without freaking out your skin. If you like this sort of video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel, and make sure you click the notification bell so that you don't miss any videos. Retinoids are vitamin A derivatives. For example, tretinoin, retinol, differin, which is adapalene, and tazarotene. They're really popular ingredients in skincare, and it's also in Accutane, which is isotretinoin, an oral medication. They have very powerful anti-aging, anti-acne, and anti-pigment effects, and there are lots of scientific studies to back them up. The main drawback to these holy grail skincare ingredients is irritation. This means dry, flaking, peeling skin, stinging, and redness. This usually happens in the first few weeks until your skin eventually gets used to it. Some people don't get this irritation at all, and for some people it takes up to 6 weeks to stop. Out of the retinoids, tretinoin is one of the most irritating, but the benefits are also best supported by the evidence. Tazarotene is more irritating, but adapalene, retinol and retinaldehyde are less irritating. I was particularly scared to start on tretinoin because back when I tried 1% retinol, I went a bit too hard. I have pretty resilient skin and nothing really hurts it and it recovers really quickly. Not so much with retinol. I use too much too quickly. My skin's actually quite sensitive to it and this irritation has a bit of a delay. It doesn't happen the next day, it happens the day after. So it's a bit harder to adjust how much I use based on my skin's feedback and you need to have some self-control, which I don't really have. I also had a cold at the time and so I blew my nose a lot and I think the combined irritation gave me broken capillaries. Since retinoids increase skin irritation, they can also cause purging, which is when a product makes your skin worse before it gets better, because basically it makes your skin expel all the baby pimples that were there much faster. I have a video on how to tell if your skin is purging or breaking out, and whether to stop your product or to wait until it blows over. Purging is worse when your skin's irritated, so it's best to add the tretinoin in slowly so that your skin can adjust. The two main ways to limit how purgy your skin gets is to introduce the product slowly and to look after your skin. And so that's the aim of my tips here. Retinoid products tend to come in lots of different percentages and it's recommended that you start with a formula that's as gentle as possible. So for example, you can look for lower concentrations and time release. Cream formulas are also more gentle than gels and they also tend to be more effective at delivering the medication to your skin as well. There are a few different strategies for adding retinoids in slowly. Basically, you want to put it in as slow as possible without losing patience. Some strategies are using a lower concentration and building it up. So you can use the lower concentration in the formula, or you can try to dilute it with oil or cream. You can also try alternate day application, which is pretty self-explanatory. Just use it every second day or third day at first. There's also short contact therapy, which is where you apply the product like a mask and rinse it off. There's a few studies where short contact gave good results. In one study on acne, a daily 0.05% tretinoin cream applied for half an hour gave comparable results to leaving it on, and a lot less people, about 20%, had irritation, even without a moisturizer. Other considerations include using mild skincare, so using gentle cleansers and moisturizers, and avoiding things like acid exfoliants while your skin's getting used to the retinoid. You should also try not to apply the retinoid while your skin's wet, because it's easier for ingredients to penetrate wet skin. So after you cleanse, wait about half an hour before you apply it. It also helps if you apply the product evenly. You tend not to apply very much, and so you want to spread it out over your skin so you don't end up with hot spots. One technique is to dot it around your face and rub it in. You can also dilute it with a cream or moisturizer and then put it on as well. I'm using my routine as an example that you can follow or you can adapt it to your own needs. The product I started with was 0.05% tretinoin, or retinoic acid. The brand name is Retin A, but I used a generic version, which in Australia is $30 for 25 mL, which is much cheaper than most non-prescription retinoids. And it's a lot better regulated, so it has a much better chance of working the way it's intended. For the first week, I did short contact therapy with half an hour in the evening, 3 days apart. I used a half pea-sized amount each time and washed it off with a gentle cleanser. I used really gentle skincare, like a humectant toner and moisturizer. I tried Stratia Liquid Gold and Dr. Jart's Cicapair Cream, and I found that Cicapair was more effective. For my first week, I had zero irritation or peeling and only a little bit of dryness, but I also didn't really have any results, although I didn't get any new pimples. So the next week, I stepped it up. So the second week, I left it on my skin, but I applied an oil underneath. I put a really thick layer of oil, so something like Stratia Fortify or Huxley's Secret of Sahara Oil Light and More, and then I applied about a quarter pea amount on my face. The oil helped the cream spread around really evenly, and I used a moisturizer afterwards, so the same ones from the first week. On the days I wasn't using tretinoin, I used a humectant toner or a really weak AHA product. This is when the peeling really started. There was a lag time of about a day and a half, and so I would start peeling in the middle of the day, and it would clear up after about a day. There was also a bit of dryness and some mild stinging. One tip for makeup, if your skin's peeling, is to just use concealer rather than foundation, because it makes the flakes look a bit less obvious. By this time, I was meant to get a few big pimples around this time of the month, but I didn't get any, which was nice, but it could have also been a fluke. I also noticed that some post-inflammatory hyperpigmentation was fading a bit faster than it usually would. Because that went quite well, for the next 2 weeks, I applied the tretinoin to bare skin every third day. I used a quarter pea-sized amount, and I put it on dry skin, and I tried to keep it away from areas that get really irritated and flaking, so around my nose and around my chin. I put moisturizer on afterwards, and I used a weak alpha hydroxy acid product the night before. For these 2 weeks, I started with some irritation, but by the end, I pretty much had no irritation or peeling. By the end of week 4, I could use the tretinoin every second day. I've talked about my final routine in detail on my blog, which I've also linked in the description, but here's the gist of it. I have a 3-day schedule which rotates. On the first night, I use a quarter to half pea size amount of tretinoin. On the other days, I alternate between alpha hydroxy acid and vitamin C, and I use niacinamide on all the nights. I found that this was the best combination for me. In terms of results, I found that tretinoin really helps with the texture of my skin, so how smooth it is, how big my pores are. It also helps with how my skin looks, so it's a lot clearer and a lot glowier, and this is probably down to the fact that tretinoin makes your stratum corneum more compact. This is the layer of dead skin cells on top of your skin. I have found though that I still need alpha hydroxy acid to keep the clogged pores in check, and I still need vitamin C to fade the hyperpigmentation much faster. I found that with this routine, I don't get much irritation or flaking while I still get all the benefits of the ingredients. I made a lot of mistakes when I first started, so I'm listing them here so you don't make them too. My first mistake was using way too much, way too often. This is a really easy mistake to make, especially if your skin is generally quite resilient. Treat it like it's kryptonite. Mistake number 2 is using the retinoids and then using other irritating things like alpha hydroxy acids next. I accidentally used 10% alpha hydroxy acid during week 2, and the next day I had the tightest and most stinging face when I was applying basic things like sunscreen and foundation. 5% was okay for me at the beginning, 10% became okay for me later on, but at the start, just don't do it. I also made the mistake of using a humectant toner before applying the retinoid at the beginning, and later on I realized this made my skin more permeable and more prone to stinging. So I hope you found this video useful. If you did, give it a thumbs up, and you can subscribe to my channel for more videos like this. You can also follow me on Instagram @LabMuffinBeautyScience and check out my blog for more nerdery. See you next time.